Hi guys, welcome to the Coding Live YouTube channel. Today I'm going to talk about installing JMeter in your Windows log machine. After that, I will do some scripting and show you how to use it. First of all, we have to download the JMeter. To download the JMeter, we have to go to the Apache site. By typing jmeter.apache.org, you can go to the Apache site. Once you go there, you can go to the download section. Inside the download section, there are binaries and source. For the Windows, we will download Apache JMeter zip file. So once you download it, you will get a zip file. So by unzipping it, you can open the folder. This is the default view of the JMeter folder which we have downloaded, and inside the bin there are two executable files. First one is Apache JMeter executable jar file, and the other one is Windows batch file. By double click on both this option, you can open the JMeter, but this one option is enough to open the JMeter. Once you double click on it, you will open the JMeter file like this. Now we have installed JMeter. Let's see how to do a script with this JMeter file. To do a script, you need a... Once you open the JMeter, you can start recording. To start recording a script, we can create a test plan, but like manually, or you can use a template. So here I will show you how to create a test plan with a template. If you go create a template and open a recording option here, you will see there's a pop-up. If you are already planning to record on some website, you can add here and you can create a template. This is a recording template which has all the components we need to record. So here we have user defined variable, request defaults, HTTP cookie manager, and also main component is the thread group. Under the thread group, we have used recording controller to control the record. And see the results, we use view results 3. So apart from that, we have HTTPS script recorder as a disabled component, so we can enable it. Now, here all set to record from the JMeter side. Now, we are going to set up the browser. To set up the browser, we are going to open the settings from menu and setting in your preferred browser and search for network setting. Network setting, open the network setting. Under network setting, you can select the manual proxy configuration. So now this browser will communicate through this proxy. So here, normally we use 8080 to general communication in your browser, but here, as you see, we are using the port 8888 to record with the JMeter. So we have to set the port here as 8888, and the same port should use here to connect. So this is how we do the proxy communication through the JMeter. You can use any number here. If you are using something else, you have to make sure that you are using same in here. Now all set. And there's one more step. Once you click on start button here, there will be a prompt like this. If you are a first time user, once you click on that, you will get a root certificate in your Apache bin folder. So once you get the root certificate, what you have to do is you have to double click on it and install it. So install the certificate. So on current user, keep the default settings and install it. Once installed successfully, you will see this message. Now there's no any bottleneck to record your script. Now you can start again and click OK, and you will get the transaction controller. So how do we check whether we have connection made properly with the browser? So to check that, you have to accept the risk at the moment because it's going through the proxy server, so that's why it's start like that. So now you have started recording. Press stop and see whether it's recording. So here under thread group, under it has been recorded. We haven't done anything, so now it's only this one has been recorded. So like that, we can start recording and continue it. I will show you few recording steps that will be helpful for you. So here I will put the transaction name as page load. Now I am going to find for flight. So I have to put the name here. Then I will select the country and the location, destination, and I do find flight. Now I am going to choose flight. So likewise, we can continue recording. Let's see how our script has recorded. See, you can see the recording for load page. So here for the find. Find flight. Sorry, this is a noise, I think. Can remove it. This is a find flight because we have to check the domain whether we are going to correct transaction. Then we can see choose flight. So these are the recording that we have done. So hope you have get a good idea on this. So stay tuned. If you have questions, post in the comment below so we can answer them. Thank you.